What is the truth? The Bible is not a scientific book, and we should not read it that way. We do not go to a mathematics or physics book for poetry, entertainment, or spiritual inspirations. Likewise, we should not turn to Genesis or any other book to look for a scientific description of the creation of the world and the origins of the human species. Genesis was never intended to be a scientific treatise on the origins of the world. We need to adjust our understanding of the form and process of God's creative energy in creation, as many theologians have done. Does that mean Genesis isn't true? The answer is that Genesis teaches theological truth rather than scientific truth. The theological truth is that God was the original spark of energy that set the universe in motion. Creation is good, and we are to care for it. Evil was not God's design, but results from humans turning away from God and pursuing their own ways. Genesis is not a geology, biology, or anthropology text. Our theologies cannot be based on the literal reading of Genesis because it is far too narrow to help us encounter God. What do we mean by truth? Karen Armstrong, an author and religious thinker, speaks of two distinct but complementary ways of arriving at the truth, mythos and logos. Both are essential, but each has its distinct competence. The primary way of searching for truth is the mythic, mythos. Its realm is that of meaning and dealing with what is timeless and constant. It deals with questions that people have asked for thousands of years about the origins and meaning of life, the foundations of societies and cultures, pain and suffering and death. Mythos is rooted in the unconscious. So this type of truth cannot be rationally proven. Myth is not a bad word. In popular culture, it means something that is not true or doesn't exist. But in the world of biblical studies, it means a metaphorical and symbolic way of expressing profound truths. Logos is rational, scientific, pragmatic. It is concerned with fact, the external, that is, real world, innovation, and the future. But it cannot answer ultimate existential questions or soothe pain and sorrow. When the roles of mythos and logos become blurred or they are applied incorrectly, serious problems arise. It is not possible to answer existential questions adequately using science or reason. When we try to do this, the result is often clashes and negative reactions. In the same way, we cannot answer scientific questions or make policy decisions using a mythic approach. If we do, we end up with educated people seeing all religion as backward and dangerous, and people who are fundamentalists seeking to turn back the clock and silence all disagreements. This is good advice for approaching the cultural wars we are engaged in, as well as for dealing with the challenge of evolutionary and materialistic views of the universe. The world's best scholars have shown that when it is properly understood, the Bible and modern science can coexist. For more stories, please visit our website, www.pamphletstoinspire.com.